Let's go back to the farm for a moment and follow turkeys right through the dressing process. This turkey ranch houses over 3,000 breeders. Turkeys are brooded under hovers, the same as chickens. And to enforce the strict sanitation so necessary in raising turkeys, pens and sun porch with a wire mesh floor are provided for the young birds. Another system commonly practiced when brooding on the ground is to move the young birds to a fresh range each week. Modern nutrition methods have made it possible to raise the birds to maturity on wire, but the most common practice is to move them to a range as soon as they are old enough to do without the heat. With hundreds of birds in the flock, the ground soon becomes contaminated and they are moved to a clean range each week. It is very important not to use the ground over which chickens have been run. Many birds are dressed on the farm, but in concentrated production areas, well-equipped dressing plants have been established. Modern conveyor systems receive the birds and carry them through all the processes to the cooling room. A knife in the skilled hands of the workman in the background severs the jugular vein and pierces the brain, relaxing the muscles so the large feathers may be pulled. This is a decided improvement on grandfather's sharp hatchet. The conveyor carries the birds through a hot water bath, held at 128 degrees, which loosens the feathers but does not cook the skin. Scald and roughing remove only the coarser feathers, and the birds are carried over a tank of melted wax, which comes up and coats them with a tightly fitting sheath, which grips each pin feather. As the hardened wax is stripped from the carcass, practically all the remaining feathers are removed. Although the wax process leaves the carcass in a very clean condition, final inspection catches the occasional feather that may have escaped the wax. With heads wrapped in waterproof paper for convenience in packing, the carcasses are removed from the conveyor to racks, which are wheeled into the cooling rooms for prompt chilling. It is important that the internal temperature be lowered as quickly as possible to preserve the quality. United States standards prescribe the various grades for the dressed carcasses. U.S. grading is optional, but is practiced by many plants. Birds are sorted by size and grade and packed in boxes or barrels. In recent years, the single-layer box has become the most popular package. Each bird is handled carefully, and the packing table is padded so the carcass does not get bruised. This careful handling in every step of the process enables the American public to get its turkey in prime condition. Because of these modern methods, turkey is no longer just a holiday bird, but is eaten all year round. Needless to say, chickens are dressed by these same modern methods. Turkeys and chickens are also prepared in the dressing plants in such a manner that they are ready for the oven of a city housewife. The birds are drawn, inspected by a veterinarian, washed under high pressure to assure cleanliness, wrapped in cellophane, placed in an attractive package, and quickly frozen. These birds must be delivered to the consumer in a frozen condition in order to maintain their quality. Thank you. for the nervous bride faced with the important task of roasting her first turkey, an attractive booklet of recipes is included in the package. To ensure the continued improvement of poultry products, the United States Department of Agriculture, through its educational program, encourages the diffusion of knowledge to both the producer and consumer. Farm boys and girls, such as these 4-H Poultry Club members, study improved practices and demonstrate them in public. Information is carried into the homes of the consumers by bulletins, newspaper articles, and radio. The timid husband is given instructions on carving his first family turkey with hints on locating the joints and keeping the bird alive. All the research, all the producer's work, the dressing, the marketing, the consumer education leads directly to the great consuming public, to the American family, the center of our democracy gathered around the festive board, not only to satisfy the cravings of the inner man, but also to give reverent thanks for their abundance and to intensify the family spirit. Thus, poultry meat makes an important contribution to American ideals and unity. Not only on holidays, but every day. In fact, every morning, we start the day with a delicious and nourishing plate of bacon and eggs. Have you ever thought of eggs as nature's most perfectly packaged food, as sunshine in sealed packages? Within the shell of the egg are all the elements needed to support life. Proteins, minerals, vitamins, compounded by nature in such a delicate manner that the most clever chemist can only imitate. Eggs can be prepared in many appetizing forms. In fact, one famous chef has said that all cookery depends on the egg. This is no modern observation, but has come down through the ages by recipes passed from mother to daughter and from ancient manuscripts. Eggs, when combined with other ingredients, go to make up cakes, pastry, salads, soups, dressings, and many other forms of delicacies. Eggs are an all-year-round food and all-weather food. They are relished from the tropics to as far north as man can go. The high-strung athlete depends on an easily digested food such as eggs for nourishment. The hurried Wall Street broker has only time to stop for his favorite fountain drink, the raw egg. Eggs supply not only nourishment, but also contribute to the decoration of food, a nutritious decoration, the icing on cake, meringue on pie. What more fitting for a crown on such a luscious piece of pastry than the fluffy mound of egg and sugar tinted a delicate brown by the genial rays of the oven? What outing or picnic would be complete without delicious fried chicken, cooked to tender crispness at home or broiled in the open over glowing coals? Doctors and nurses rely on poultry meat and eggs in making up the diets of invalids and infants. Eggs are the first solid food of that most important consumer of them all.